Welcome. This video tutorial offers a step-by-step guide on how to merge two columns in Excel. In our example, we'll merge a person's first name and surname in a separate column in a quick and easy way. The same way works if you'd like to merge larger amounts of data to avoid tedious typing and copy-pasting. Let's see how to do that. Hello and welcome to EasyClick Academy. My name's Frank, and together with our EasyClick team, we're here to make sure you'll be able to use Excel in a quick and easy way thanks to our digestible video tutorials. To merge two columns in Excel, first we need to select a target cell. Here we'll use the cell D3, so we click on it. Then we click on the button marked with FX up here, which is the Insert Function button. In the pop-up window that's just appeared, we select the category All and look for the function Concatenate. Now we click on OK and here pops up another window where we can easily merge the data from these two columns. Thanks to the function Concatenate, you can merge up to 255 different items in one cell. But first, you'll see only these two fields, Text 1 and Text 2. Here, you can enter the data to be merged. If you'd like to merge more items than just a first name and a surname, more fields will automatically appear once you click into the last visible box. This way, Excel can gradually open up to 255 text fields. Let's have a look at how we can enter data into the fields. We want to merge and create a full name in the format first name, space, surname. In Text 1, we need to enter the first name. So we click into the field Text 1, then we click on the cell containing the value we want to use. In this case, B3. If we want to add a space between the first name and the surname, we need to enter a space in the field Text 2. Which is very easy. We just click into the box and press the spacebar. As soon as we click into Text 3, Excel will encode the space by adding quotation marks around it. The same way we can add, for example, a dash, a colon, or any symbol we need. We'll keep the space in Text 2 and move on. In Text 3, we enter the surname again by clicking into the box and then selecting the cell C3, which contains the data we need. As we are joining the strings, here we can see a preview of the full text. Once we've merged all the data, we click on OK, and that's all it takes. The first name and the surname have been joined without tedious typing or copy-pasting. To merge the data in the rest of the rows, we don't need to repeat these steps row by row. We can just set the cursor on the cell containing the inserted function and drag its bottom right-hand corner down all the rows where we want the function to do the trick. Like this. And before we wrap it up, there's one important thing to remember. To change the merged text in a target cell, we need to change the information in the source cell first. This is because the target cells do not contain the text itself, but rather the function concatenate, which takes data from the columns we've merged. So let's say we'd like to change the name Tommy to John. To do that, we need to navigate to cell B3 and make the change right there. The text in D3 will change based on what we've done in B3. And if you'd like to keep just the text in the merged column rather than the function, it's no rocket science either. First, copy the data in the merged column using the Control key and C. Then press the right mouse button and choose Paste Special Options. Here we're going for the option Values. This will turn the function inserted in the merged column into the resulting values, and you can further work with the text itself and modify it as you like. If you found this tutorial helpful, give us a like and watch another video tutorial by EasyClick Academy. Learn how to use Excel in a quick and easy way. Is this your first time on EasyClick? We'll be more than happy to welcome you in our online community. hit that subscribe button and join the Easy Clickers. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.